Good morning. I wanted to show you today how to do some basic stitching with your kindergartner. The first thing you'll need to do is have a sewing needle. They're a little bit longer in the kindergarten so that they can hold them a little easier. Once you get the thread in on your needle, we tie a knot at the top end. This will keep the yarn from slipping off of the needle. And then we tie a little knot at the other end for the stitching, like this. Now, we have two kinds of stitching that we use in the kindergarten, a dolphin stitch and a whip stitch, thank you. So first I'm going to show you the dolphin stitch. You would use this if you had two pieces of fabric that you needed to sew together, one on top of the other. So in this case, it's a little bird with a wing, and I'm going to use this kind of needle to hold that wing in place, like that. I have this pin in through the wing, and I'm going to do a dolphin stitch. And we tell the children you're going to dive out of the water and then carefully dive back in, just like a little dolphin would jump in and out of the water. And it would make this little stitch. And if they are just learning to stitch, they will need some guidance of where to poke. So if they come far away from the stitch, they would need a little guidance on where to put that needle next. And the dolphin would jump out of the water and into the water. And you would continue all around that wing with that particular stitch on this one. So once you have your wing on in this particular example, you would then have two pieces of felt that would need to get stitched together. You would take a pin to hold the felt together for the children so it doesn't slip and slide. Depending on how big the fabric is, you might need two pins. And this next stitch is called the whip stitch. To start the whip stitch, I start on the inside between the two pieces of fabric just to hide that knot. And they take their needle and they whip it around to the other side of the fabric, just like that. And then to do the next stitch, you would go right next to it. They want to make sure their stitches are beautiful and somewhat even. Of course, that will depend on their age. And I will continue to go around the entire bird. And they will look something like this. Now, when you get about 3/4 of the stitches done, you would pause and then stuff it before finishing it off towards the end. So those are your basic stitches. So these are the two basic stitches, the dolphin stitch and the whip stitch.